I will see you all. I will see you all. I will see you all. Y'all. Y'all. I gotta start saying y'all now. All right. Hope you're doing well today. We're doing a little like Mythbusters video today. It's kind of the theme of this, let's say, episode. Let's do it. So I've been asked this question a lot, especially let's say after these videos I've done on cheating and the ways people cheat. And people ask me, Matt, does the chapstick thing or the lip balm, the Vaseline, does that really work? Does it? And I'm like, are you asking because you want to know if it works, or are you asking because you want to use it? I don't know, but we're going to uncover that mystery today with some real data. All right. So let's jump into this thing. By the way, I hope you're liking these videos, and make sure you hit the like button and subscribe to the channel so you don't miss anything. And all the products that I use and recommend, there are links in the video description below. Not for the lip balm. Figure that out on your own. Okay, so you gotta watch out. Do you gotta watch out for homeboy who's constantly lipping up? Or maybe do a little baseball move, put a little Vaseline on the inside of your cap and just do a little one of those deals. So that's the question that we have to ask ourselves. Does it matter? So the theory behind the lip balm, this is Burt's Bees, pretty good stuff, by the way. Tastes pretty good too. Anyways, is that when you apply it to the face of your club, okay, that it would reduce the amount of friction that the ball makes with the club face, therefore reducing spin. Specifically, side spin is what we're trying to avoid, so that ball doesn't slice off too much. So either way, it would reduce all spin, not just side spin, but all spin in general. So here's what we're going to do. We're gonna hit a number of shots, regular, okay? No petroleum jelly on the club face. Then we're gonna hit a bunch with it, and we're gonna look at the numbers and see if there's a difference, all right? Okay, so first what we're gonna do is we're gonna hit with the clean club face. That makes a lot of sense, because then we don't have to clean it after, all right? So I'm all warmed up. I've been warming up. We're good to go, and there we go. Oh, we got Pro V1X golf balls for everybody, so we're gonna use the same balls. These are all the same. Everything's the same. There's no wind. The environment is totally controlled in here. That's what I love for testing. I don't want wind. I don't want not anything. Just me. It's the only downside. Okay, so let's see what happens. And that was a bad shot. That was a good shot for evaluating stuff, because that was a big slice. So that's good. But we're gonna kind of get, we like 10 shots, get average number for the 10. And then we'll do that, because I want averages. I don't want just one time. Okay, tired. So my average spin rate is like 2,300, which is pretty low. I just got a new shaft on here, so we're not gonna spin down anyways, which is great. I'm a little off side to side, just getting used to everything, which is fine. And now let's apply the stuff and see if that changes anything. And we also wanna just kind of look at dispersion numbers, kind of get a good idea if that is gonna change too. So dispersion wise, with nothing, I'm hitting a lot of fairways. I'm kind of left and right at the moment. That's on me, okay? So I'm a little wild, typical of how I drive the ball anyways, so that's good to know. I like it. We got it. You got it. We're going to change it up. I don't like doing this. All right, so here's what you would see, or this will be an exaggeration. Look at that. That's a good amount on there, that's for sure. Okay. It definitely makes a mark. Kind of reapply it. Do it again. Kind of what you see, usually see people put it on their lips and then they do, and they rub it in, and then they do a little that guy. All right, what do you think? What do you think the numbers are? Did it help or did it hurt? Okay, the average spin numbers using the lip balm were actually higher than without the lip balm. What? Can you believe that? All right, and now my dispersion with the lip balm shots were center and left of center, primarily. Interesting, right? And I had a little bit more carry in comparison to without the lip balm. Huh, what do you know about that? And my dispersion with the without the lip balm, without, was a little more kind of all over the place versus just with, it was more central. It just shifted more left. It stayed left or center. And I got a bit more carry on average with the lip balm. However, I was getting more spin, but that makes sense, right? Because you get a little more spin, that ball's gonna kind of stay in the air longer, whereas without, it's going to go down and run out. So what's interesting, the total distance with lip balm and without lip balm is interesting, because without, it certainly went lower with less spin, believe it or not, and hit and rolled more. Versus with the lip balm, it carried farther and just landed and didn't roll. But I would say that with the lip balm, the side-to-side stuff was less than without. Without it, I did go side-to-side more, but I felt like, but I was getting less spin even with that. But with the lip balm, it didn't go side-to-side. The side-to-side spin wasn't so exaggerated, but the backspin was more. I don't even know why that would happen. So my theory about with the lip balm and why it spins backwards more, but side to side less, would be this. I mean, you're striking, the club's moving this way. So the predominant movement of the motion will be kind of going forward, and there's loft on the club. So that's going to kind of take over. And then this direction, even if the face is open or closed, that direction is going to be the prominent direction of the club. And then the secondary motion would be the spin. It's not shifting side to side off the club face as much. So in conclusion, I think this does actually help when it comes to side to side spin. And then in terms of backspin, I think you get more backspin off of it. So I actually think it increases the amount of backspin, but decreases the amount of side spin. If that makes sense. Why would do that? Why would you get more backspin? And the reason I say you get more backspin is this. So my theory, I'm no scientist, but what's happening is you're adding something to the club face, okay? You're putting something on there, okay, that actually has friction to it, okay? This has some type of, everything has some type of friction. And I would say that the lip balm is going to have more friction than just a pure you know, face of titanium or whatever they're making the faces out of, that I think there's a lot less friction on just a clean natural surface than there is if you put some type of product on top of it. Because that's, then it's going to have to, on some micro level, the ball's gonna have to, you know, travel through that even to get to the club face, and that little bit of stuff is gonna create some friction. And it's going to add spin to the ball. That's my theory. I don't know. I'm not dumb, but I'm not like rocket scientist either. So let me know your thoughts, what you think, comment below of why you get more backspin, but less side to side spin. That's why I think it's doing it. Because one, you're adding something with some friction to it. But two, because the main direction force is backwards and forwards, that's gonna be prominent. And then it's not gonna have time to sit on the club face long enough to grab that side to side spin. Whereas without it, it's immediately on the natural club face surface, and therefore it will grab side to side more than without. So I like to work the ball on purpose. So I think I would not, I wouldn't use this anyways. So I mean, if you're using this, you got some problems. Let's face it. But hey, it is not a total myth. It does help in some ways, and it doesn't help in other ways. There you go. Mystery solved. Sword. Anyways, hope you got a little entertainment out of this video. Thanks for watching. Love you guys. I'll see y'all in the next video.